Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer to. I'm half crazy, all for the love of you. It won't be a stylish marriage. I can't afford a carriage, but you'll look sweet.
Hello, Cubanwriter here with Darklingfae.
Hello.
And today we're reviewing a very special trailer for the Hitman's Bodyguard. Now let me give you a little background. What happened is I saw this trailer pop up on someone's feed on Facebook, and I hit play, and I watched it, and I thought, well, this must have been a kind of a joke trailer.
Not a real movie.
No, like...
Oh, not a real trailer.
Probably one of the late night shows made
not a
fake
a real
trailer.
Movie.
They were having Samuel Jackson and Ryan Reynolds on, and they decided, oh, let's throw together a fake trailer where they're like buddies and a...
Maybe this was when Deadpool hadn't turned into Deadpool yet.
It must be.
This must be some of the... We're getting to see finally some of the jobs he did prior to becoming made into Deadpool.
Yeah. So after I clicked like on the video because I thought it was funny, and my wife watched it, and then we were sitting around and we said, that wasn't a real trailer, right? I mean, there was no... night show logos or anything. And then we looked it up and we found out this is a real movie I have just never heard of before.
I still don't buy it. I think it's just a big joke.
So we're going to look at it again and share our thoughts about what we're seeing. So here I go. Click play. So he's AAA rated. I wonder what the rating agency is.
Maybe Yelp?
Could be.
Or the Better Business Bureau, because obviously this would be the type of business that you would put on the Better Business Bureau. Yeah, Katarina agrees.
Maybe it's the Better Bad Business Bureau.
It could be.
For bad businesses like Hitman
it could
stuff.
Be.
Or he's a protection agent. So I guess you know what? A protection agency could be. It's the Hitman that couldn't have a AAA rating.
No, he's not the Hitman.
Right, he's the protector. Protectors can get AAA rating.
Where? Like who?
In the security industry.
Who does the rating?
The security industry people.
Exactly.
Okay, here we go. By the way, I thought In a Dangerous World was funny because it reminded me of that Fontaine guy who was like, in a world that is very dangerous. You know, remember those old voiceovers? Everyone needs a bodyguard.
It's my feeling too, Samuel L. Jackson. That's my feeling too.
I mean, it's definitely a comedy. That's probably why we got the vibe
that
it was...
We're 24 seconds in and I already think it's not a real trailer.
It's probably the reason why we got the vibe that it wasn't a real movie is because it's a comedy and that's coming through like they're making a joke. We just didn't realize the joke wasn't the movie itself.
It is. That is the joke. Yeah.
So he says motherfucker here. It's the first of many times he will say it in this short trailer, but let's continue.
Well, that's a Samuel L. Jackson thing now.
Right? But that's the thing. It's such a Samuel Jackson trope, and when I heard it so many times in this trailer, I thought, oh, they're making fun of how he always says motherfucker. They are making fun of how he always says motherfucker, but they've made a whole movie about it. Was that funny?
No.
No.
I didn't
actually... I love That's What She Said jokes, but that one didn't land with me. Okay, so what was the thought there, do you think?
This is a joke. The entire thing is a joke from start to finish. Like, it's like a Dumb and Dumber
It does seem like
movie.
It does
There's
seem like they've
nothing
transcended...
about this so far that makes me want to see it.
I feel like they've transcended humor and
I
gone
liked
into...
it better when it was not a real trailer.
Yeah.
And I still don't think it should.
Because then it was funny. It was like, oh, did they post this on April's? On April Fool's?
Yeah, they should have, because...
I'm sure he follows right after that doing it.
I hope they kill him. I really do.
So, you know, I really like these kinds of movies usually, these kind of comedic hitman movies. They're almost a genre of their own, but this one just doesn't delight me. I feel like it's just a series of tropes.
Well, it's like the scary movies.
Yes.
Where
is this the scary movies of Hitman
things? I guess.
The first scary movie was okay.
I mean, I have to say the thing that I actually, I know you thought I was crazy, of the Hitman movies that were based on the video games, like they were a total cheese fest, but I thought they were fun cheese fests. There's nothing fun about this trailer so far. Like, I haven't laughed. I mean, it really shouldn't be a real movie.
I kind of watched it the first time with a half smile on my face. Like, oh, they're making fun of all this stuff.
Like, oh, they have a sense of humor about...
about their own work. About,
yeah, but it this really should never be a movie.
Yeah, there's another Samuel Jacksonism. This should be called Samuel Jacksonism the Movie.
Yeah. There's...
See, another Samuel Jacksonism. It's a series of Samuel Jacksonisms. There's another one. I will admit that one made me giggle a little, but then again, this is also the moment where I began to doubt myself. I was like, that's expensive for the Late Show to pull off a stunt like that.
Well, I didn't
that.
Think it was anything for the Late Show. I just thought it was a joke trailer. I didn't think.
Well, but
I
then thought, who would like, be funding it?
Ryan Reynolds for his Deadpool thing. Like, I thought like this would be like previews that you get to see before the actual Deadpool sequel.
That would
it
be
seems
hilarious.
Like something that it would. It seems like something that he would do, and that would make sense.
What was the name of
this
that movie?
Cannot be a real
in
movie.
The jungle where they were making fun of Apocalypse Now and all that.
Oh, Tropic Thunder?
Yes. Remember those fake trailers in Tropic Thunder?
Yeah,
I feel like this could have been amongst those.
Yeah, and I felt like this was like something that he would do and get some friends together that, you know, he's worked with before that don't mind making fun of themselves. Like, that's honestly what I thought. And that's really what it should be.
Really? What happened to the seatbelt rule?
Of course, they're using this song because it was in The Bodyguard with...
Yeah, it just makes you miss Whitney Houston more than anything.
So, what was your final thought on this trailer? Do you want to see the movie?
No.
Yeah.
I like it better when it's not a movie.
But you know, we're going to have to see this movie.
What? No.
They're going to want to hear
you
the
owe
review.
Me.
My 7 subscribers.
You?
Is it 7 or is it more now?
I don't know.
I haven't checked in a while.
My
subscribers want to see us review this movie.
No, they don't.
They do now.
No.
Maybe now.
No.
Well, this has been Cubanwriter signing off.
Goodbye, darling.
Catch you next time.
But you'll look sweet upon the seat of a bicycle built for two. Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer, too.